Hello dear student, in the previous class we have discussed about n-type semiconductor, p-type semiconductor and the difference between n-type and p-type semiconductor. So on the basis of that, so now we are moving on to the next concept, that is p-n junction. PN junction. This is the next concept of the chapter semiconductor, that is PN junction. So what is here P stands for? That is P stands for P type of semiconductor, and N stands for N type of semiconductor. So now define the PN junction. The junction between a p-type and n-type semiconductor which the crystal structure remains continuous at the boundary is called PN junction. So what is the PN junction here? The junction between a p-type and n-type semiconductor such that the crystal structure remains continuous at the boundary is called PN junction. So nothing but the PN junction is the junction between p-type and n-type semiconductor. So let us see the next concept, that is the construction of PN junction. Construction of PN junction. So in a single piece of a pure semiconductor, so that is a pure semiconductor here, silicon or germanium. So one half is doped with p-type impurities and another half with n-type impurities. The plane separating the region is known as p-n junction. Okay, so when a single piece of pure semiconductor, so one half of is doped with p-type impurity and another half is with n-type of impurity. So now let us see the action of p-n junction. So this is the very important concept here, action of p-n junction or formation of depletion region in PN junction diode. Okay, so this is the very important concept. So that is the formation of depletion region in PN junction. So now first let us see the diagram. So this is the diagram of formation of depletion region in PN junction diode. So here is the p type of semiconductor, here is the n type of semiconductor. So in p type of semiconductor, so here it is trivalent atom. So that impurity is here, trivalent impurities are added. Here pentavalent impurities are added. So because of that, here the electrons are majority charge carrier and here holes are majority charge carriers. So therefore, so whenever the formation of p-n junction, so that is p-n junction means it is connected to an external battery. So that is nothing but here potential barrier V naught. So we are consider this one as a potential barrier V naught. So this is the p type of semiconductor and this is the n type of semiconductor. Okay, so here is the immobile positive ion. So this is the indication of immobile negative ion. So these are immobile positive ions. Okay, so there is a reason here. So this reason is represented as depletion reason. So this symbol indicates holes and this one is the immobile positive ions. And here in the orange, the dot represent electrons. Similarly, the negative sign, immobile negative ions. So then the symbol of on the negative sign, so that is represent here the representation of impurity atom in the p-type semiconductor. So similarly, so this symbol represent here the represents the impurity atom in the n-type semiconductor. So this is all about the diagram. So now let us see, in a single piece of pure semiconductor, so the pure semiconductor here is nothing but what? Silicon and germanium. So one half is doped with p-type impurities and another half with n-type impurities. So the plane separating the region is known as p-n junction. So the plane separating the region is known as p-n junction. During the formation of p-n junction, due to concentration difference, holes from p side diffuses into n side and electrons from n side diffuses into the p side, so produce a uniform distribution. So p types are holes are majority charge carriers and in n types are here electrons are majority charge carrier. So from the n types are here what? The electrons are diffuses into p types. So from the here holes are diffuses into n type. So that is formation of here what? Uniform distribution. So on crossing the p-n junction, these electrons and holes recombine. Okay, so here is the recombine. So on crossing the p-n junction, so here electrons and holes recombine. As a result, there is a formation of thin region consist of immobile positive and negative ions. So near the junction. Okay, so here is the formation of thin region. Okay, so here is the formation of thin region consist of immobile positive and negative ions near the junction. This region is depleted of mobile charge carrier is called depletion region. So what happened here? So this region is here depletion region. So here is the electrons are diffuses into p side, here holes are diffuses into n side. So there is accumulation of positive and negative charge. So this region is called as here depletion region. So this region is called as here depletion region. So then the width of depletion region is about 10 raised to minus 6 meter. The width of the width of depletion region is about 10 raised to minus 6 meter. So that is nothing but micrometer. The net charge in depletion region is 0. The net charge in depletion region is 0. Okay. So due to the immobile ions at depletion region, an electric potential difference is developed across the junction called junction potential. This junction potential stops for the diffusion of electrons and holes. Hence, it is also called barrier potential. Okay, the equilibrium barrier potential can be altered by applying an external voltage V. So that is the capital V. So whereas we are discussed in the diagram. So that is capital V across the PN junction. Okay. So now let's see some important definition. So first one is here depletion region. The thin region A, thin region consists of immobile positive and negative ions near the PN junction depleted of mobile charge carriers is called depletion region. So what is the definition of depletion region here? A thin region consists of immobile positive and negative ions near the PN junction depleted of mobile charge carrier is called depletion region. So the next definition, junction potential or barrier potential. Due to the immobile ions at depletion region, an electric potential difference is developed across the junction is called junction potential. Due to the immobile ion at depletion region, an electric potential difference is developed across the junction is called junction or barrier potential. Okay, so next see the semiconductor diode. Semiconductor diode. A semiconductor diode is a PN junction with metallic contacts provided at the ends for the application of an external voltage. So it is a two terminal device. So semiconductor diode, it is a two terminal device. So is a PN junction with metallic contacts provided at the ends for the application of an external voltage. So is called semiconductor diode. So the next concept, the circuit symbol for circuit symbol for PN junction diode. Circuit symbol for PN junction diode. So it is, so the diagram is as like this. So this is the two ends. So this is the positive and this is the negative. The arrow points from the P side to N side, and it signifies the direction of conventional current. Okay, so this is the circuit symbol for PN junction. So this represents positive and this one represents for the negative side. So next we are moving on to the another concept. So that is biasing of PN junction. Biasing of PN junction. When no external voltage is applied across the PN junction, it is said to be unbiased. When external voltage is applied across the PN junction, it is said to be biased. Okay, so when no external voltage is applied across the PN junction, it is said to be unbiased. When External voltage is applied across the PN junction. It is said to be biased. Okay, so what is biasing here? When no external voltage is applied across the PN junction, it is unbiased. When external voltage is applied across the PN junction, it is said to be a bias. So there are two types of biasing. One is forward biasing, the second one is reverse biasing. So there are the two types of biasing. First one, forward biasing. The second one, reverse biasing. So now in this class we are discussed about what is PN junction. So PN junction between a the p-type and n-type semiconductor. So the junction between p-type and n-type semiconductor is called PN junction. So the next, the construction of PN junction. So that is nothing but here the single piece of pure semiconductor. So that is nothing but silicon or germanium. Half of is doped with p-type impurities and another half with n-type impurities. So the plane separating the region is known as PN junction. The next concept, that is a very important concept, the formation of depletion region in PN junction. So we already in detail we are explaining with respect to our diagram. So the width of depletion region is 10⁻⁶ meter. So that is nothing but micrometer. The net charge in depletion region is zero. So next, the some basic definition, that is what is depletion region. So that is the thin region consists of immobile positive and negative ions near the PN junction, depleted of mobile charge carrier, is called depletion region. So next one, what is the junction potential or barrier potential? Due to the immobile ions at a depletion region, an electric potential difference is developed across the junction. So that is called junction potential. So in the last concept, that is semiconductor diode. So it is a two terminal device. So it is a PN junction with metallic contacts provided at the end for the application of an external voltage. Okay, the symbolic representation of PN junction. So that is the positive terminal, other one is the negative terminal. So that is signifies the direction of conventional current. So the next concept is here biasing. The biasing is nothing but external voltage is applied across the PN junction, then it is called as bias. If it is not, that is unbiased. On this basis, again it is classified into two type. One is the forward biasing, another one is the reverse biasing. Okay, so remember, there is a note for you guys. At room temperature, for germanium, junction potential is, junction potential is 0.3 volt. So for silicon, junction potential is 0.7 volt. So it may be helpful for your CET exams. So the for germanium, junction potential is nearly 0.3 volt, and for silicon, junction potential is 0.7 volt. So in the next class, we are in detail discussed about the what is forward biasing and what is reverse biasing. Okay, thank you. Continue in the next class.